decentralized exchange is one of those things, same with prediction markets, where it's the holy grail of crypto. There's certain things that you can only do with crypto, and it seems very ambitious that you're trying to do both, or how does decentralized exchange fall into hypnosis?
Sure. So yeah, as I mentioned before, so if you have a look at Augur, for example, the issue is that you have lots of prediction markets, they're all traded on Ethereum itself, but it's not really efficient, like hardly anyone's trading, and this is because the way their decentralized exchange is implemented doesn't allow efficient trading. And the reason for this is that they are using an order book model. Yeah, order books is what everyone knows from centralized exchanges. That's how commonly trades are done today. And order books, they require the concept of continuous time. Yeah, so you have to have continuous time because order books use a continuous auction where you can place orders, and if it's a market order, it's immediately executed. If it's a limit order, it stays in the order book until it's matched. And this is a continuous process. But if you look at blockchain, then blockchain doesn't know continuous time. Blockchain only knows block time. And in blockchain, what we actually do is we collect transactions over time, and then the miner decides the order execution and what transactions are included, right? And now, if you try to use the order book model within a blockchain model that only knows block time, then there are issues. And those issues are that front running can happen. And the issue of front running is that there's an information advantage for the entity that can manipulate the transaction ordering. So for example, let's say someone wants to place a huge Ether buy order on any exchange, and the miner has to process this transaction first. And the miner sees that there's someone wants to buy a lot of Ether and drives the price of Ether up. So the miner would just place their own buy order first, then process the other buy order at an already higher Ether price, and then in the same block they could sell the Ether again for a profit at the expense of the one who wanted to buy Ether. And that's just a fundamental issue with blockchain today. And the other issue is, and that's maybe even more crucial for Augur, for example, is that because there are markets with low liquidity, you have big spreads between bid and ask. So in many markets you have a bid-ask spread of 20, 30, 40%. And this prevents people from participating because they always have to pay the spread in order to do anything. And that's why we believe this model doesn't work. It's currently used by every decentralized exchange, including EtherDelta, 0x, and so on. But if you want to reach bigger adoption, then you have to really do a paradigm shift of how decentralized exchanges have to work. And we believe that we can change this fundamentally by using auction mechanisms where we batch orders together in one auction, and then the auction defines a single clearing price for the token. The Dutch auction is one example of how you can do this, and it works very well on blockchain, and that's why we decided to go with this kind of model. And yeah, we hope that that this can become like an exchange which is especially interesting for low liquidity tokens, because we aggregate liquidity over time and then define a single clearing price.
Is there any example of something like this out at all in the world right now?
Absolutely, yes. So actually, if you have stock exchanges and they pause trading for some time, for some reason, then they actually also do some sort of batch auction. So it's not that we fully invented this kind of concept, absolutely not. It has been used already. But in this concept for doing a decentralized exchange, that's a new type of model. And it comes with advantages, but also disadvantages. So if we look at the Dutch exchange, obvious advantage is we aggregate liquidity, and there are lots of tokens which don't have liquidity, but the whole process becomes slower. if you have an order book, then at least you have some sort of instant trading. You'd only depend on the block time, and that the miner includes your transaction. With the Dutch auction, it works like this. If you want to sell the token, you have to fund an auction. Now, let's say you want to sell GNO for Ether, then you have to fund the auction with GNO tokens, and when a certain threshold is reached, then the auction starts. And the auction always starts at twice the price of the previous auction. So let's say if GNO was sold in the previous auction for $30, then this auction will start at $60. Then the price of GNO will go slowly down based on a decaying price curve. And this curve is implemented in a way that after 6 hours, it will hit the previous market price. So after 6 hours, it would hit $30. Okay. And around that time, you can expect that the auction will end unless the token price changed significantly. So the ETA for an auction is always about 6 hours. And that's, of course, a long period of time. And that's why we also call it like the slow trade exchange, where if you want to exchange value as a seller, then you have to wait for a couple of hours before you get the other token in return. But for many tokens, this might still be very the preferred option, because you know that you're getting the same price as everyone else, and you get a fair price, and you don't have to pay the spread that you have to pay on other exchanges, which is significantly, especially for low liquidity tokens.
Yeah, I'll definitely keep track of this. This sounds extremely interesting.
Yeah, it's about to go live in the next 2 weeks, I would say. And then, yeah, the great thing is that because we don't have an off-chain order book, there's not any like centralized entity, right? So if you think about decentralized exchanges today, we always say they are decentralized, but are they actually decentralized? And I guess the best way to answer this question is always to ask if you have to ask for someone's permission to do anything, right? And if you have an off-chain order book, like a centralized off-chain order book, then you actually have to have the centralized entity to agree to maintain the orders for your token. Mm-hmm. So it's somewhat permissioned. And with our exchange, it's purely on-chain. There is no order book. So you really don't have to ask for anyone's permission. So it's the first fully decentralized exchange of tokens. And that's why every project that has their own token can just use a smart contract to add their own token pair without asking us for permission. And by doing this, add more liquidity to their token.